What's up, y'all people? Hello. This is something like the 542nd day episode. 542nd episode. Make it Songbringer. I'm working on my Trello list, which is a bunch of stuff that I just notes that I put down when I played the game on the recent beta update. Actually, I had a really great time playing it. It's such a great time. I kept playing it for hours. And it was like the first time where I really got that engrossed. So something has really, really changed recently. There's been some really great changes that just make it more engrossing. The game is very, it just kind of carries you on this sort of quest. So working on my list here, one of the things I'm working on now is that Brutus, when I played last time, he didn't have any dialogue for me, and so something was off with his settings. I think I have it fixed already, so I'm just going to, I'm testing it now. I'm making sure I test. There's three different things, basically. There's three different kinds of dialogue. One is if you have the sword, one is if you don't have the sword, and another one is if you do have the sword, but you don't have Jib. So all of those kind of require different, you know, different dialogue. What's up, PX? Okay, so I need to test it with all those situations. How you doing today, PX? Okay. Oh, thanks, Dieharders and Wolfrock. All right, so to test this, we tested with Jib, with sword. So now let's try it without Jib. Thanks, Metrius. Oh, you had a hard day at work, huh? What's that? Hello, Sketch Skit. Cool name. Sketch Skit. So cool. So this is without Jib, so can't have Jib's dialogue. Okay, that's good. Now, it doesn't matter if we have Jib for the next one, if you don't even have the sword at all. Oh, dang, man. Sorry to hear that. Thanks, Galaxy 5000. Okay, so that's the version where you don't have the sword, right? Okay, so now if I save any one of those, I should have gotten the item Brutus, which prevents you from getting that dialogue again. But also I got Brutus 1C, which is this one, which will... Okay, so all these are mutually exclusive as well. So we can't have Brutus 1 or 1C for this one. And this one can't have B, or I mean 1 or B. Yeah. All right, cool. Nice. I'm using the engine called Cocos 2DX. It's a C++ engine, open source. So yeah, 1C can't have 1 or 1B. 1B can't have 1 or 1C. And 1 can't have 1 B or 1C. So that just prevents them. Basically, if you, it clears out this Brutus item as soon as you go down into a dungeon. So it would have been possible to get that same dialogue twice had I had the sword one time and not had the sword another time. So, anyways, those extra little Brutus's checks there ought to prevent that. Let's. Okay, now I gotta test them all again. So we have Brutus 1C. Let's get rid of that and get rid of the Brutus so we can see these again. So what was this one? This one's without the sword. Yeah, okay, that's that quick dialogue. And if I save, now I know it. I already know that'll work. Okay, so now let's try with the sword. Right, that's the dialogue with Jib. And saving gives me Brutus once again. And Brutus 1. Okay, so this time I want to see without Jib. Okay, that worked. Great. So all those work. Yay. So pity about the difficult of making these games like Nomoria, RimWorld. You know what? I don't know about any of these games. I've heard of RimWorld. I heard RimWorld's really good. Oh, it's like a bit, you like build bases and stuff. Sci-fi colony sim. This is kind of like Prison Architect, huh? Is that right? D inspired by Dwarf Fortress and Firefly. The difficulty of making games like that? What's the struggle? What's the struggle? You mean what are the difficult parts of making this kind of game? I guess, yeah, there's a lot of complexity here. Every little entity has so much going on. I don't know. It kind of depends on the game. I would really have to play this game to tell you what are the difficult parts of it. I don't know. I don't know enough about it. I would imagine the complexity and the play balancing too. Play balancing is a huge thing with the games like this. It takes forever to like make sure everything is just like all perfect and balanced. Programming in any video game is always the hardest part. Programming takes the most amount of time. So, you know, an artist draws stuff and it's done. And then, you know, of course they refine their art and stuff like that along the way, but a programmer has to do so much work. They have to code things, they have to debug things, they have to test things, they have to fix bugs. There's like and everything is so goddamn time consuming. So if anything, programming a game like this is going to be some, in general, going to be the most difficult thing, I would imagine. Okay, so that time I saved, I'm gonna delete the Brutus and make sure that even though I have Brutus 1, it doesn't play Brutus 1B because I don't have Jib. Okay, so that worked. Yeah. Okay, so I'm checking that in. Brutus has dialogue no matter what. No matter what. Let's check that one in. Brutus didn't say anything. Well, he does now. Okay, which one's next? Which one's next? I'm looking for the easy ones. This back and board Songbringer cutscene could actually be pretty easy, but it's a bit involved. Oh, these would be great. Yeah, we made it back to Songbringer. That's a good one. Okay, so the first time you teleport back to Songbringer, it should have like some celebratory dialogue. Like, yes, we made it back to Songbringer for the first time. We finally got the teleport cube. Okay. So we'll start off. Wait, let's give it. Let's start right back where we were, actually. What's up, professional novice? How you doing, man? Okay, so I got the teleport cube? No. I need a teleport cube, man. Give me one. Okay, so right here is where we need the dialogue to to happen right away. So let's start back where we were. And this should be a pretty easy dialogue element. Do I have one called Ship One yet? I guess it would go before these myth ones. So it would be called story ship. Yeah, I got ship bridge, ship engine, ship door. Call this ship. Ship homecoming? Yeah, let's call it ship homecoming. Z ship. I guess this has to have jib. And doesn't matter what else you have, except for your, you shouldn't be done. You should be done fluxing, so you're done with the teleport. All right, now we need some dialogue for that. Oh, ship homecoming, you should definitely have jib for this. So I don't need to do multiple dialogues for this one. This is gonna be cool. Rocket Bunny, what's up, man? You're cooking tacos. Nice, man. Yeah. Right. Wait a minute, isn't there a super easy one on my list here? Was is always there? Oh yeah. Was it always there? That's such an easy one. Yeah. Yes, I do. Yeah, I cook a lot of my own meals. It's cheaper, and I like to be able to choose my own ingredients, and choose the way in which I cook my stuff. Okay, so ship homecoming. Let's see if this works. Without following recipes, yeah. I hear you on that. That was you, Rocket Bunny. It said your name on the main menu right then. Oh, that thing shouldn't have a shadow. It looks so weird. Hold on a second. That's the roast. Oh, there it is. No shadow for you. Roast. The problem is dishwashing. Wow, the game almost runs at 60 frames a second now. While I'm streaming, I had to turn it down to 30 there. That's cool. It's getting a little bit to perform a little bit better. Right. Yeah, we have to hand wash our dishes too. What a struggle. Oh, what a struggle. Hand washing dishes. There you go. Okay, so we're ready to try this now. Why didn't it trigger that? Z ship, exist jib, not fluxing. Ship homecoming one. Did I spell it right? Ship homecoming one. What? Huh. Well, I guess, okay, I'll start with story verbosity. What's up, Truzer? What's my favorite programming language and why? Sounds like a school essay assignment. So it should be triggering this dialogue right now, but it's not. What's my favorite programming language? I guess I like C and C++. Why do I like it? Because it's fast, it's portable, it's simple. But I'm looking forward to future evolutions of that style of language like Jai a lot. Dishwashing makes you eat a lot less cheese. It is, right? It's hard to get cheese off stuff. So I'm wondering why this dialogue isn't triggering. And I think last time it didn't even have a story action. Flux open, zero actions. Not even considering it. Why isn't it considering this action? Let's try taking off the exist jib. Still nothing. How about we're not even checking if it's fluxing? Same thing. Okay, something's real funky here. I guess I gotta debug this one. Dang. It's gonna be a time-consuming one. Okay, well, story actions. Story system. It's called can run. That's where it actually, here's where we want to look it up. Okay. So if and node dot key equals ship homecoming one. We want to check that out. See, why can't it run this action? Because you're not alone. Thank you, Flying Zombie. Appreciate it. I have not used Live GDX. I don't use Java. I've heard good things about Live GDX though. I've known of several people using it to make games. Okay, there we go. We got this action caught. Caught it in the middle of the action. So, what's going on here? Here's our node. This node is called ship homecoming. It's got a Z range, negative two, and all that. Okay. So it passed the Z range check and the key check. Even has jib, uptime, near to, defeated. We're not spawning. We can run the action. What the hell? So we can run this action, but it's just not running it, or what? What's happening here? Possible. Oh, it's pushing back a possible node. Continue to here. There's only one possible action it can run, which should be ship homecoming. No flag match. Grab a random element. We should get the same node. What's happening here? I bet this is some stupid mistake, some simple thing. Just type something wrong. There's no actions. Seriously, there's no actions. There should be an assert for that. Oh, what? Oh, give me a break. All right. Assert. Node.actions.empty. Not empty. Do assert one on this. Story action. Has no actions. Story node by that name has no actions. And this is node key cster. All right, there. Now we got a freaking assert so I can catch this. Let me see. Why would it have actually not have any action? Oh, I called it action instead of actions. All right. So hopefully we get this assert message now so that I can catch that in the future if I type action instead of actions. Oops. Let's make this obvious when you make dumb mistakes like this. Assert fail. Wait, no. Assert fail. Yay. Story node, ship homecoming one, has no actions. There. Hopefully that'll save me some time in the future. I have to do that again. All right. So now we need to fix the action. That was easy. All right, let's see if it works. Oh, Jib's right behind that. I was like, where's Jib? Cool. Why is that? Why are errors hard to solve? Okay, let's see that from, I'm gonna start from back of the overworld. We'll teleport to Songbringer and see if that feels right. Okay, I'm gonna turn off the story. Verbosity. All right. To Songbringer. Yeah, we made it back to Songbringer. Awesome. That's all I wanted to see. One little story element. When you get back to Songbringer, you're like, yeah, we made it back. All right, so I changed a few things. I added that story element. And what's the code thing I changed? Oh, yeah, the assert for no actions. That's a beautiful thing. Oh, I added some random line there to story. That's weird. Don't need that. That's all we changed. All right. Dialogue for getting back aboard Songbringer. Cool. One more off the list. I like these simple, easy things. Love them. Oh, yeah. Okay, so we're going to do these next ones. Rosenbaum and Guildenstern have individual dialogue. And then I'll also do don't do the Smith quest if you just did the intro. which you should probably do first. Logically, that's the first thing that's going to happen. All right, so we'll go into that room. Oh, and I should save this. Just make sure it doesn't play it again. Yeah, cool. That's a one-time story element. All right, so we get here. What dialogue is he gonna do? This is the initial dialogue. Okay. So we start off in on the ship bridge. We need to have crafted something. Don't think I have anything crafted here in this save file. Actually, let's do this right. Make sure I get all the story elements for that. So I have ice. I'm gonna go craft like icy something. And save, yeah. Do the ice bombs this time. Thank you. Okay, so that gave me ice bomb. And I also got Smith one, Smith success one. Okay. So now I have the ice and the ice bomb. I'm gonna go into okay, I got it. I got it. Okay. So the thing is, with this next story element, I don't want it to trigger like this second bit of dialogue if we've done the first bit of dialogue this play. Or at least if you haven't reset the Z, so if you haven't teleported out of the area or, elevated out of the area or whatever. So What I'm going to do is I'm going to add a flag to areas that basically an area can once it's run an action, a single story action, that area will always remember that it had run some sort of story action before. And just in general, and then the story system can check for that. So the story system could be like, okay, I don't want to run this certain action if this area has run any action before. And then it will reset that whenever you teleport. So I'm going to do that. We'll just call it did story. All right, and then when we reset the whole area, this happens when we reset Z, it does did story fall, so it triggers that back. So things can trigger again if you've been to a different Z level. Okay, and then the story system is what's responsible for saying this area has run an action. And I think I'm just going to do it when it first does the action initially. Yeah, I have plenty of those. I'm sorry, but I don't know how to tell you which ones they were. But I can give you a link to the channel and all the profiles stuff. You sure? Are you going somewhere?
Yeah, I'm sure.
Oh, all right.
Okay.
Okay, baby. See you when you get home. We're gonna kick that board tomorrow, or there's a potato. Beans, we grab some beans. There's that, and if you go there, there's two playlists. Don't know if I don't know how to do this. How do you search for? I guess you have to search for it. What's up, Z? Thanks, man. How you been? You want to learn a programming language, but they look intimidating? Well, what would make a programming language less intimidating for you? Can run, and then it goes run action, is that right? So basically what I want this to do is, here's where it goes, if run action, run action's immediate, oh. Here we go, where it chooses, where it actually initializes a node, this is where it does it. It picks a random node that can run and then runs it. It's going to take the current area and give it that flag that it's done. I guess we don't have the area. Mark area as having run a story element. Area dot did story equals true. Yeah, well, I think of it like this. Like, have you learned to like drive a car before? It's kind of like that. Or even learning to ride a bicycle or something like that. At first it's intimidating because there's a lot to learn. When you're first learning to ride a bicycle, man, you got to learn how to like keep your balance and pedal and all that stuff. And then it gets more complicated. Like you learn to drive a car and at first it's intimidating. You're like, "Whoa, there's all these dials on the dash." Especially if you're learning to drive like a clutch car or manual transmission, you've got like to pull out on the clutch as you're putting on the gas just right. You got to shift gears just right. You know what I mean? It's a lot to take in when you're learning to drive. You can't just learn to drive in one day. Maybe you did. I don't know. Maybe you're some amazing person, but you probably aren't going to be an amazing driver after just one day. It's the same thing flying a plane. It gets even worse with flying a plane. Flying a plane is even more complex. You're like, whoa, there's way more dials. There's like all these controls and things like that, and you got to learn how to like talk to towers and all that kind of stuff. It's the same thing with programming in general, because it's like it's difficult at first because there's so much to learn. But once you start learning one little thing at a time, right? You learn one little thing, like what does int mean in C++? Int is just an integer variable. If I say int I equals 0, that's an integer variable named I that equals 0, and I can add to it like, oh, I want to add 1 to that I variable. That's I plus equals 1. You feel me? You learn one little thing at a time, and you get to know that one little thing, and you will become familiar with it, and it won't seem intimidating anymore. Okay, so that marks the area as having done a story element. We've got it so it resets that too. Oh, there's one last thing. When we're running actions, ahoy, salad dongs! Welcome, welcome. How are you today? Okay, so now if the area did story, then the story status is always going to have did story. I've been good, man. Busy as hell. I'll tell you that. This last update was a doozy. But so rewarding. My last playthrough of Songbringer was my favorite playthrough I've ever done with it. The game's come a long ways. Yeah, busy's very good in this case. And then I got GDC next week, so I'm probably not going to stream much next week. Maybe I'll do some like Periscope streaming next week or something like that, because I'll be mostly at events and stuff all of GDC week. There's so much going on. Like I won't even be able to code much the whole week. And then a week goes by, and then I'm at PAX on the East Coast in Boston. And so that's going to be another like 4 days of not coding, but cool because I'll be able to interact with people and just have fun for a while, you know, not code. It actually is going to be really great to not be making my game for a little while because I'm on the borderline of being burned out, you know, all the time because I'm just pushing it so much, 7 days a week, you know. Yeah, definitely. I hope to have some fun and relax and just not code. If only all of making games was as easy as making art and music. Yeah, definitely. So today I'm mostly just making art and music, I guess. I was. Now I'm doing some code. Okay, so but let's check out what we just did. I got this new flag called did story for all the areas. Starts off false, it resets to false. And then whenever an area runs a story element, it's got this new flag called did story. And then it triggers that into the story system. So now we can give the story element for giving you the Smith quests. Is that ship bridge? Yeah, here's the captain's note, Smith quest, this is it. So ship bridge 2. Not 3? No, just 2 looks like. Okay, so I've got the items. Got all the items for to make this happen. Okay, so if I go up to go to the bridge, it's gonna trigger the dialogue, the initial dialogue, and then it's gonna trigger the next dialogue, which I don't want to happen, but I'm just gonna make sure that this story element I'm gonna add, or this predicate is going to make it right. Okay, cool. So it does this initial dialogue. And then if I just sit here, it'll trigger the next dialogue. Yeah, okay. So that's the bug. Or not the bug. Yeah, it's pretty much a bug. All right. Okay. So now ship bridge is not did story. So if we've done a story element here, then we cannot run ship bridge 2. So I'll do this again. Yeah, he does. He does. He gets a Bluetooth headset. Is that funny? Oh yeah. Right? English is hard, right? So many rules and special cases. Okay, well, I'll go in here. Do the first dialogue. It shouldn't do the second dialogue. But if I go and teleport away and come back, it should be able to do the second dialogue. Good. Okay. It does this other story element, which is okay. We could do this anytime. Great. And if I go out of the room and come back, still shouldn't be able to run this action. Okay. So we'll teleport now. And then go back. Yeah. Oh, maybe it didn't reset. Oh, you're saying English is easy. Yeah, I know some Spanish, but I don't know Portuguese. Okay. It didn't reset. Probably because it didn't call it from the world. Where's that reset? Yeah, world reset Z. This is it. So, what calls world reset again? Only two things: flux, arrived dungeon, or arrived overworld. So let's see if it even calls reset when I teleport. I don't know if that works. Yeah, it did. All right, so I'm gonna set a specific breakpoint this time. If V3I 0, 1, negative 2, it should be resetting did sorry here. It's just not, maybe not doing that Z. So that's resetting 0, the overworld, because we arrived at the overworld. So once again, oh, okay, so flux teleport, it does arrived overworld. So it never resets the Okay, I'm just gonna do it manually for this. This is a special case. If new area pause.z is the ship, then we're gonna world reset the ship. Our new area pause.z. Okay, from the top. Let's save that first dialogue. Okay, which was ship bridge. Why did he do that? Oh, I already have the comm. Is it? I want to turn off my alert sound. Oh, yeah. It's impossible to understand? Really? Oh, it just goes library sounds. So I've got a silent wave, raw wave, silence. I'm gonna copy that to library sounds. So I can make my That's not right. Huh. Oh, there it is. Okay, I just had to restart. There, now you guys don't get that boop boop noise every time. Always thinking about you. Okay, so let's try this again.
Yeah.
Okay, if I sit here for a minute, it should not trigger the next dialogue, except for this one. This one's okay. All right. And that should be able to run every time, too. So oh, damn it. I didn't want to save and quit. Ah. Oh. If I teleport to the overworld, I go back. Now I should be able to trigger this next story element. There we go. Cool. That's awesome. And I can reuse this technique, this having not ran some story elements. I can reuse this in so many different story situations. This is just a good thing to have for the future. Okay, so we've done all those dialogues. Let's save that and check in this so far. So the ship bridge 1B, you can have done story. Or Shipbridge 2. Got the digs. Oh, the area reset. Oh, hey. Yeah, another one off the list. Don't do the Smith quest if you just did the intro. Okay, next one was Rosenbaum and Guildenstern having individual dialogue. Okay, that should be mostly data. Actually, hopefully this is all data and this would be a simple one. This is ship. Oh, Shipbridge 3 should be able to run. Yeah, that's a no save. So Shipbridge 3 can run every time. Shipbridge 4 could too, but 4 is only happens once. What's up, RuneWord? It's going well, man. How about you? How's it going? I think this one will be story, Shipbridge 3A. This is if you're just talking to Rosenbaum. And 3B will be if you're talking to Guildenstern. The game is coming along very well. It finally has a release date, so it's coming out this summer, and it's also coming to PlayStation 4 and Xbox. I'm excited to announce. So I'm going to create two more story elements for talking to these individual characters. Not Countdown. Has Ship Bridge won? You have to be close to Rosenbaum, though, for this one. Like at least 50. Dialogue Ship Bridge 3A. That looks good. We'll do two of those. This one is exists Guildenstern. Shipbridge 3B. Okay, so we're gonna create some individual dialogue for both of these characters. Rosenbaum's a girl. She thinks Rock is hot, so she's gonna be all attracted to him. Guildenstern is sort of like a techie dude. What are they gonna say? What are they gonna say? Okay, let's see if that works. Okay, so Shipbridge 3 doesn't need as much delay after it. What happened there? Oh, I got her name wrong right there. Oh yeah, thanks, Valk. You totally tell you called it. Should have read the chat. Yes, yeah, I use a tablet. I also use a mouse sometimes. Mostly for editing, but I use a graphics tablet for drawing. Also, we shouldn't be able to do that twice. So once you've talked to Rosenbaum, that's like a one-time thing. I think Jib is going to talk to Guildenstern. Thanks, Kiku. Hi, Guildenstern. Hi, Jib. If I give him a percentage. Oh, wow, yeah. This is only going to run once. Okay, I could do that. All right, let's see that again, and I'll save it and make sure it doesn't run twice. But other than that, I think these two story elements are good to go. This time we should get that for that always dialogue. And then if I stand here, we shouldn't be able to get the Guildenstern dialogue again. Good. We already talked to him. We can talk to Rosenbaum though. Okay, now just to confirm. Got the captain's note. Got ship bridge 3B. Which should be, yeah, that's Guildenstern. All right. All we changed with data there. We got dialogue elements for Rosenbaum and Guildenstern. Another one done. Okay, any more easy ones? Looking for easy ones. This back aboard Songbringer cutscene actually could be pretty easy, and I'm already there, kind of. But it'll take a minute to finish that one. All right, we'll do it. Okay, so I'm gonna do a new cutscene. Depends on what time it is. What's 5:30? How long have I been streaming? Okay, we got enough time to do this. It's gonna be like, trip one. Okay, so trip one is gonna be how it triggers. Trip 1A though, we're gonna be going to a specific place where we've already been. So we need to do some special dialogue for this. So it only triggers if like it's a cutscene. Wait, does story system already do that? Oh yes, it does do the flux type. It's currently running. So we can say flux dash cutscene. I think, wait, gotta confirm this. Start this off. This is the pattern ship bridge. And I want to do is flux cutscene. I think that it's right. Is flux cutscene. Not fade in. We'll just do a delay first. Delay for 2 seconds, then run dialogue, ship cutscene, 1. Okay, now in the code, sub rocket. No, Valtry is just data. If statements are code, data versus code, data separate from code. In where does it trigger trip one? There it is. Fade out, end. Elevator down. Oh, right. Okay, so where do we actually trigger this? It's going to be in fade out for when we're going upstairs in the second, the dungeon with the teleport. Oh my God, how am I going to know that? Let's just see if we can even get it to work right. I'll start by going to dungeon 2, where we want this to trigger. Well, this might be dungeon 3 or 4 in this world. Oh no, it is dungeon 2. Okay, and I want to go to the Verloc room. And we're going to be walking upstairs, so I'll save here. Okay, this is where we're going to do this dungeon. It's either dungeon 2 or 3 always. I guess I could add a story requirement that's called dungeon item or dungeon goal item, dungeon gate item, and then it would go through the dungeon. Yeah, I think what I'll do that at the end of this. So we'll start with Z0 is manual. Or not Z0. Z is like either 2 to 4. Okay, and when it does this, does it set the new flux type? Yeah, well, it sets flux segue there. So this is gonna be upstairs, ship, cutscene one. Is there a world find pattern? Yeah, nice one. Find pattern for K ship Z. K pattern ship bridge. Oh yeah, and this is gonna restore this new area pause. Oh, this is Flux Segway. That's right. I don't know. JavaScript has changed a lot lately.
Be right back.
All right, so good. The data is gonna need to be Flux Segway though. That should be it. It'll restore its new area pause there. Okay, so if we walk upstairs, will it actually do any of this? Oh, we need a dialogue ship cutscene one just to see if it actually is working. Ship cutscene one. We'll have something like Captain Tusk says dot, 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 just so we know. So if I walk upstairs, we should trigger this. Oh, no dice. I don't have cutscene one, do I? Ship cutscene? Yep. What's up, you're ragging great. Okay, so you got that. Pattern ship bridge, ship cutscene Z 2 through 8. Was that the Frumzy? Oh, we want to test the 2Z. That's right. So we want to do the new area here. If the new area is Z, 2 through whatever. Oops. Yeah, I am working on story elements again. All right, man. Okay, well, the next thing would be to debug it, figure out why. Flux type should be upstairs. It is. And we should be able to run this action, ship cutscene one, on the new area. The new area has a position of 342, which is Z2. We should be able to run that. But we can't. Okay, let's figure out. I gotta, I guess, step through that actually then. Can't ignore this, gotta step through it. Okay, so we're trying to run trip 1A. Trip 1A. What? Oh man, I'm so confused now. So confused. Oh, it never even got there. Oh. See, we're in flux and phase right here. Okay, so I set a breakpoint inside can run, and it never got in here. So it went through all the story nodes, and there's no story node named ship cutscene 1. Did I really just mess that up with that easy of a ship cutscene 1 right there? Okay, what the hell? There, okay, we found it. Step into this can run function. God, why did it not work last time? Wait, what? Create zero NPC. Oh, it's filtering. Filtering out this. Okay, so Z predicate. Z predicate doesn't work really right here. It just does a ship cutscene no matter what then? I guess so. For now, I'll just keep it like that. I just want to see this dialogue, get this working. Do a title here. NM's title. Ship cutscene 1x. Okay, the dialogue worked, but it didn't do anything for Captain Tusk. Why is that? Ship cutscene. Sorry. Oh, is it ship cutscene 1A? No. But it should be. That didn't work. Everything's not working all of a sudden. Action dialogue. Should be getting this. No, we don't. Why would that happen? It does this anim right here. It does a delay of 2 seconds. Is that part of it? Maybe it needs a delay afterwards? What the hell? Alright, I guess I need story verbosity. Alright, we got no actions upstairs. Alright, what's up? Delay 2 seconds. Do dialogue. Oh, but only do it if you're at this area? What? Wait, what? How does the... Maybe it does need... Old area? God damn. Thank you. Well, I'm gonna have to give it a little break right now. This is kind of frustrating. I think what I'm gonna have to do is go back to check on how trip one works exactly, because it works. It runs dialogue for everybody's entities and stuff on the area. It works fine. I don't know why. Right, trip one. It's like definitely not Z0. I don't know. I gotta work on this. Just get it to, I don't know, take a break on it. So, that's gonna be it for today's stream. I'm gonna sign off here so I can get some rest and think about how the hell to do this. But it should be cool to have a little ship cutscene. So it kind of like builds up the fact that, because I mean, at first you don't have any contact with the ship. You don't even know there is a Songbringer for a while in the first, through the first dungeon. And then the second dungeon, the story element is going to be that you eventually get the teleport cube so you can talk to Songbringer. So I want to build that up a little bit, do some foreshadowing and stuff like that. So this is going to be a segue to that scene there on the ship. That's it. So thanks a lot for watching, everybody, and we'll see y'all next time.